Well, you are definitely passionate about this, but I'm thinking about the also thousands of other doctors that perhaps are not, that perhaps, to your point, don't have the time, aren't willing to give the time to really invest in their patients and make sure that they get the proper care from the monetary funds, if you will, from the insurance companies in order to make sure this happens. Where do you see this going? I mean, obviously, this has been something that we have been dealing with, I guess, since the beginning of time. It, yet again, because of what happened, this has spurred this conversation. But we got to find a light at the end of the tunnel, do we not?
Yes. So where I see this going, guys, that this is an opportunity for a pivot. We have got to take a hard look from the legislative standpoint, from the administrative standpoint, and the private as well as the publicly funded healthcare plans, that we've got to come up with solutions that put the people first. We've got to put the health as the forefront. It has to be that conversation, and not just being aware that this is a problem, but you know, I'm all about going from awareness to action. What are we going to do about it? So I think where this is going is it's going to be a better change in the environment and the culture, because the individuals that are at the forefront of making these decisions are really being pushed to the task. Like they said, listen, something has to change, and you have too many people that are pushing for insurance carriers to do this differently. We need to have more human interface. A lot of times, you know, there's great benefit, I think, to AI, but for many of the decisions, it's automated. They're algorithms. They're not real people making these decisions on behalf of the patients. And so I see there's going to be a positive shift, but like most change, it oftentimes is going to be difficult, an uphill battle in the beginning, but this is where we have to start, right here. Mm.